HD News Weeks 4 to 8, a cheating scandal, Saint Players, Masters Finals, Tactics Change, a site to tell you if you are lucky or not, and is Hattrick hiring or a turtle? Let's start with the Hattrick Masters. In the final, we had the massive longshot team Smoking Lirunana from Sweden playing against the monstrous Viajapura Vipers from Brunei. We had a great final, high ratings and no man marking at all. Chance distribution went 5-5 and the winning goal was scored by Smoking Lirunana at minute 19 with a long shot. It was all they needed to lift the biggest trophy in Hattrick. The replays are massively in favor of the Vipers, 75-25 for them, so sorry McVie, I know you deserve this, but it's part of the game, and congrats to Bell from Sweden for winning the Hattrick Masters for season 79. I wanted to stream the Hattrick Masters final, but I had to attend a work wedding. Turned out to be that the father of the bride is not only playing Hattrick, but we're actually in the same league, and I'm gonna play tomorrow against him. It was a great wedding, Shali, thank you so much, and I really enjoyed it. I want to say thank you for Nick Karna for all his massive contribution with statistics and his posts about the Hattrick Masters, and I encourage you to read his last thread about Hattrick Masters history when he's summing up, with the help of a few other managers, a lot of statistics about the game. Do you remember the HT God from South Africa, the darker side? Turned out that he played 35 tournaments in the Hattrick Masters, racking 104 games in total, more than anyone else. You could see which managers ever played with three teams in the Hattrick Masters, me included, and just amazing statistics. Thanks, Nick. Check it out. Five Hattrick Masters winners being long shots, they are definitely a force to be reckoned with. But are they overpowered like a lot of managers think? Well, maybe Hattrick thinks they are a little bit are. Yuan introduced new tactical changes that will take effect at the beginning of the next season. This is very soon in terms of Hattrick, making three tactical changes to attack in the middle, attack on wing, and pressing. Attack in the middle and attack on the wing was barely used nowadays, as you suffer the negative effect of being your defensive sector lowered while converting chances to the appropriate side that you choose almost never happens, even if you have high tactical level. And now you'll have a bigger chance to really convert attacks to the middle or to the wing and to make those tactics more viable. The pressing is directly targeting long shots. Nowadays, with low tactical level, pressing does nothing against long shots. How does pressing work? When an attack is produced, you have a chance to just destroy this attack, whether this attack is yours or your opponent's. But while playing against long shot team, if the attack is your opponent's and he is converting this to a long shot, there is another checkpoint of the pressing tactic to destroy specifically this long shot. With low tactical level, it never happens. And now Hattrick saying, if you're playing pressing, even if your tactical level in pressing is pretty low, you'll have a bigger chance to destroy those specific long shots. That's it. It will by no means kill long shot, but it's a step in the right direction to give managers a bigger and like better countermeasure against playing long shots. Some players in Hattrick are special not due to their exceptional skills, but due to their rare personality. Bob Swanson was the only ever beloved team member in Hattrick, but according to Wiki Hattrick, his agreeability was manually changed. Recent post found 7 saint-like players in Hattrick, and that never happens in terms of honesty. Nick Karna found all those 7 players and they have something in common. They were specially created as immigrants for returning managers. So, for example, you see here Jose Maxis, and he is saint-like player, but this player has a special immigrant status. This means that they could never be sold. Well, maybe there is a way if you put them into a national team and then this team will become into a bot team, but I don't like people losing their teams. So those players are never for sale, and all 7 players are immigrants with this saint-like character. I think it's pretty cool. Another thing that never happens is, in terms of aggression, we don't get any unstable players. If any one of you saw an unstable player on the transfer market or in Hattrick, please let me know. I would love to see it. And I hope that Hattrick will keep creating those players, maybe in the youth academies as well. Maybe they have something special hidden inside of them. I would love to see it. Unlike those Saint players, there are also cheaters in Hattrick. Not speaking about mass cheaters opening hundreds and thousands of team trying to win elections in small countries, I'm speaking about a more elaborate scandal, which is a financial one. Mod Malcolm Glazer from Brazil opened this thread on the Global Forum, and the situation, without mentioning names, is as follows. We have Manager X. Manager X has a second team in a small country. Let's call this team Team A. Manager X plays in a big country and he's not really successful. He's playing in a low division there. And he has also friends. Let's call their teams Team B and Team C. They are also not competitive teams playing in the lowest divisions. Every time Manager X has a player in the small country, Team A, that he wants to sell because his player is injured or in a bad form, he's placing this on the transfer market for the higher end of the transfer compare. And always Team B or Team C will buy this player with a single bid on the upper end of the transfer compare. Also, after a short while, Team B and Team C will sell those players for much less than they bought them to funnel allegedly more money due to transfer fees to Manager X's small country Team A. Mod Malcolm Glazer asking, is this fair? Is this something that should be happening in Hattrick? Does it need to be monitored? Or maybe the prices should be adjusted? What do you think? So this is the situation. If someone is allegedly trying to always maximize his profits despite players in specific situation being injured or really bad form, should not be sold by the upper end of the transfer compare. Does Hattrick has a way to battle this? Because his team in a small country is playing for titles against other teams in the same Premier Division. And those managers, maybe playing by the rules, are in a deficit, in a financial deficit against this manager. So, is this fair? What should be done? Maybe if those players being sold after a week or two for, I don't know, 60% of the price, GM should adjust the price or the primary price that the player was sold for this. Or maybe this manager should get a warning, or maybe he should be sanctioned with maybe losing his second team. I don't know. What do you think about this? Or is it okay? And having friends in Hattrick will always guarantee you getting the upper end of the transfer compare. Speaking about fairness, we have a new CHPP tool that could do just that. It could calculate whether you were lucky or not. And just like the old Haro specs, it will tell you how random was your game. For instance, you could place your match ID and calculate this, and if the result is random, it will be colored in yellow. You could say, hey, Mish, isn't that Black Sabbath? Oh yeah, I just lost a cup game this week, and I was massively favored. This site says I had 94% chance to win. The actual replays in Hattrick was 85-15 to me. Well, my season is pretty much over, but that's it. Nothing to do. Part of the game. There is another way here to calculate league prediction. I love this. So I could place the league ID and the season, let's say previous season that my team was playing it. This will take a little bit slower, and I'll tell you that the HTML is working with machine learning. He also learned by 3.5 million games up until now. And according to the real Hattrick replays or these predictions, it's pretty much okay. You could say that for the last season my team should have won the championship, but I did get pretty much exactly what I needed to, minus 1.1 points. Second place was really close to me, and the actual winner of the league, he had 8.8 points more than he deserved. He is a very strong team, and yep, luck is part of the game, and he's a worthy champion. But I could say, hey, I was unlucky, you were really, really lucky. Championship should have been mine. Again, it calculates all the games, and it colors in yellow the games that are extremely random. Another part here, Wait a second, where is this? So you have the match prediction, the league projection, and also you could custom match prediction. So you could place the ratings that you are thinking you and your opponent will have, and it will tell you the future probabilities if you hit the ratings correctly. Use this tool. We also have a thread on this on the global forum. I'll link both the thread and the site. Hattrick is preparing for its 25th anniversary and is also hiring new people to the staff. Last month, Johan said that they are looking for 2 developers and 1 community manager. Those are great news that Hattrick is growing and have some resources to put into development. We might have new features and also a community manager that will strengthen the bond between the developer team, the owners, and us, the managers. And if you want to work for Hattrick, that might be a great opportunity for you. You could send your resume there and they would really want to have someone from the game to work for them. You could do part-time from work, but they are looking for people that might be willing to move to Sweden or at least travel there often. Lastly, I want to recommend 2 articles. The first one is Rediscovering an Old Friend, a story about a manager who served in the army in the early 1990s and lost connection with his brothers in arms 25 years after he finished his service. One of them found him here in Hattrick. You want to know what happened to them? Check the article. The other one started as a forum thread called Hattrick Is, when managers are saying what's Hattrick for them. One is saying it's a community of forums, including a soccer team. Another is saying it's an economy management game with a mini football game on top of that. Another is saying it's an online football game for kids played by grown-ups in their man cave. And another manager said Hattrick is a turtle. Well, why is a turtle? An article written back in 2009 said Hattrick is a turtle. It's green, it's slow, it develops slowly, it's persevering everything. If you love and cuddle it, it will bite you. Well, it's a wonderful article. You should take a look and read it. I will link both articles in the description. And please let me know in the comment section what's Hattrick for you. Hope you enjoyed the news. And now I'm curious to know, what do you think about it? Is it okay to ask your friend to pay high transfer compare for your players? Does the tactical changes enough to diminish the strength of a long shot team? Would you want to work for Hattrick and move to Sweden? What's Hattrick for you? And are you lucky or not, according to the new randometer? Thank you so much for watching. As always, Hattrick is more than a game, it's a community. And I'll see you next time.